So, two of our matches are complete today. Another three to come, and we turn our attention once again to men's singles and the five-time former champion, Lin Dan of China, against Dries Lubberdez. Then we've got men's doubles, and Taiyun and Liu Kai up against Indo and Hawakawa, number five seeds. And then we finish off with women's doubles. So our next match, Lin Dan, the five-time former champion, number three seed this year, up against Dries Lubberdez. So the left-handed Lin Dan, well, he's already a legend in the sport. Up against a man who's pretty much a legend in French badminton, Dries Lubberdez. Eight times national champion, eight consecutive times national champion. But what hasn't this man achieved in world badminton? Lin Dan, Olympic champion, world champion, Asian Games gold medalist, All England champion, 79 career finals, 59 titles. Well, let's look first of all at Dries Lubberdez, 29 years of age. Oh, I didn't get enough chance to look at his player profile there. Oh, there we go. 35 in the world ranking at the moment. Has been as high as 22. His win-loss record for the year, well, 13 tournaments. Best so far as a quarterfinal. That was the Singapore Super Series. So to the man who turned 32 last month, the man from this province, Fujian province here in China. Currently number three in the world, has been number one. Number six on the Super Series standings at the moment. Went down a place after losing in the first round of the French Super Series, lost in three games to Pranoy. Well, this will be the second meeting between the two players, but going back to 2010, I'm not sure we can read much into that. It was the second round of the China Masters Super Series. Oh, what an occasion for Dries Lubberdez. I was chatting to him at breakfast this morning. He was telling me, he was actually following up on something we'd been talking about earlier, about Olympic qualifications, because he was telling me that his brother, who was an international judo player, got a little disillusioned with the qualification system, because in that sport, as indeed with many sports, you qualify a place for your country by certain achievements in tournaments, rather than qualifying the player.
On my left, Lin Dan, China. Rise to serve, love or play.
So the Frenchman, Dries Lubberdez, getting this second round match underway.
One love.
Six finals here in this particular tournament. Lin Dan winning five of them. First, 12 years ago, 2003, long before the Super Series came into existence. Missed it.
The match of Court 2 will be men's singles between Kato Komota from Japan and Song Won-ho from Korea.
二号场比将要进行的是男子单打的比赛，由来自日本的桃田贤守对阵来自韩国的孙婉虎。
Umpire 王正和 China. Service judge 陈尖尖 China.
裁判员王征和中国，发球裁判员陈尖尖中国。
Well, not the start Lover Days would have wanted. Yeah, he's bound to be nervous on the big stage, on the television court.
Yeah, and playing them then in China is something that every player from a country other than China is looking forward to.
Yeah, I remember Srikanth Kidambi talking about that last year, didn't he?
Yeah.
Saying how he dreamt of playing against Lin Dan in China and to be in the final of the China
Open. And then win.
And then win was beyond his dreams, beyond his wildest expectations. That's a sensational shot from Lin Dan.
Oh, that's a good sign that your deceptions are working when the opponent is going to all other three corners before actually realizing that it's in the fourth corner of the shuttle is.
Oh, yes, finds the line. He's got the whole, not only repertoire of shots and movement, he's got the whole star quality thing about him, hasn't he? Even the way he walks, it sort of, you know, screams out star quality and a sort of aura about him.
Yeah, and rightly so. I mean, he's, without a competition, the best player ever to play men's singles. I don't see anyone coming close. I mean, sometimes you can discuss who is the best player ever,
I think,
who has the best results and so on. I don't think there's any question in the men's singles.
Oh, I have my doubts, Steen.
You do?
I do. There is absolutely no question when you look at tournament achievements that he has a record that nobody else can rival.
Yeah.
But when Rudy Hartono was playing, no Olympic Games.
No.
In fact, he only played in one World Championships, two World Championships, I think it was in the end, was it?
He only played in one, in 80 where he won it.
So there weren't World Championships every year, as there are now. In fact, there wasn't World Championships. There wasn't the opportunity to play in Super Series events and tournaments throughout the year. When I think of the way badminton has developed through the BWF, IBF as it was before being the BWF, players now have so many more opportunities. So yes, his results, but if I think of the best badminton players ever that I've ever watched, I'm not convinced.
Well,
Zhao Jinhua, for instance.
The
quality of that man, he didn't last long enough on the tour. But look, you know, how can you argue with an 11-3 lead at the moment, and he's deserved the 11-3 lead. He's there is no doubting his quality. Yeah. I love watching him play.
Yeah, I was just about to fall out of my chair. Excuse me for that. it wasn't of the argument, but there's two ways of looking at it. The one who's been playing the best badminton ever is, in my opinion, without doubt, Lin Dan. I think it was done in the 2008 Olympics, where he was absolutely phenomenal.
He was.
The achievements, the level of achievement, you could say that to sort of gauge that, you have to judge the contemporary competition. Mm. And you could at least say that Rudy Hartono was extremely dominant, winning the All England 7 times altogether, 6 times in a row, or 8 times?
I think it was 8 times.
Yeah.
But you see, again, you know, we're going to have a... we can't really enter the debate because the Chinese players weren't part of the international badminton at the time, no Korean players. And therefore, trying to compare eras is desperately difficult.
Yeah,
results rise. I am 100% behind you. That Olympic final in Beijing, the way that this man played was phenomenal. And I don't think I've seen anybody play better in a particular match than that. So I agree with you on that, but you know, I think in a way it's a, you know, it was me that started this. I brought it up in the first place. But trying to compare eras is a little futile, really. You can't. But other than to say, Lin Dan is a legend, and he's one of the greatest athletes I've ever watched. Not just badminton players, greatest athletes I've ever watched.
The match on top 3 will be men's singles between Victor Felsen from Denmark and Wong Wing-Chi from Hong Kong, China.
3号场地将要进行的是男子单打的比赛，由来自丹麦的维克多·阿克尔森对阵来自中国香港的黄永琪。
Umpire Xi Shaoping, China. Service judge.
I think the other thing, sorry, I said it was futile to discuss this, but longevity, I think, is a true test of greatness.
Yeah.
You know, and it was March 2004 when Lin Dan first became world number one. He's world number 3 at the moment. You know, 11 and a half years later, that is phenomenal.
Some event during the Denmark Premier Series 14-6. Where some of the people that are behind Victor Axelsen had an event there, talking about the thing of being brand ambassadors and so on, where for some Europeans it's hard to grasp how big Lin Dan is, and there were some numbers on the Twitter accounts, and a tennis player like Serena Williams has got 5.6 million followers on Twitter, which is pretty much the biggest star in that department is Cristiano Ronaldo, with over 100 million followers, but Lin Dan has 22 million followers on Weibo.
Yeah.
So it's just so big.
Yeah. Oh, that's good. It's very difficult to know for a player. Of course, Loverdays will have dreamt about this opportunity to play Lin Dan in China. But here he is, he's 11 points adrift.
Yeah.
You know, I'm not even sure he's got a coach with him. No, he hasn't got a coach with him.
No.
So he's going to get no advice from one of your colleagues about what to do. And it's difficult to know what he should be doing in this sort of circumstance.
Yeah. It doesn't seem like he has the weapons to challenge Lin Dan.
That's brilliant.
He's been struggling in the month of October. Brice Levadier been ill or injured, as far as I'm aware. He's playing in the Danish team tournament. So his goal was to make a form peak here in November, and I think he should be. He can be satisfied by winning the first round here in China Premier and get the experience against Lin Dan. But this is a little bit, hey, welcome to the real world.
Yeah. Game point opportunities for Lin Dan. Oh, yes. 21-6, 13 minutes.
What a beautiful touch.
Yeah. Well, cruise to the opening game. Oh, if I was the Chinese coach, I'd just say, well done, mate.
Yeah.
Do the same thing. Now, just explain to us why Lovadays wouldn't have a coach with him. Is he funding himself to these tournaments? Self-funded?
I'm not really sure whether he is or not. I'm not sure he's part of the French overall national team. He's of course the best French player.
Yeah.
But he's more or less conducting himself, as far as I understand. But we've seen him being coached by the French coaches in other tournaments. So I don't think it's he's outside of the national team or something like that.
No.
He's just at another level than his competitors in France, who plays mainly the European circuit tours.
So maybe the coach is going to Scotland next week for the Scottish Grand Prix and taking the French players there.
Yeah.
But then it does become tough. I mean, there's a number of players that I've been noticing today. Michelle Lee, of course, who lost earlier on to Carolina Marin. She doesn't have a coach with her.
No.
She has to cope on her own. Very similar sort of circumstances. And it's difficult for these players like this man, Brice Lovadays. If you're so outstanding and better than anybody else in your country that you need to play a different level of tournament.
Yeah, and second game. What's often the case when you discuss it is that they say, yeah, but that's developing us. We're taking care of things ourselves and so on. And that's right in many ways, but still it would be nice to have some help to manage your trip.
Mm. Goes long. He's an interesting character. You know, he plays the guitar very well. Very good musician.
Okay.
And he says if he hadn't been a badminton player, he would have been an actor or a musician. He's certainly got the looks to be an actor, hasn't he? Film star, good looks. There you are. I think he's a bit like Tom Cruise, a blonde version of Tom Cruise.
Yeah. I have to admit, I'm not that much into French movies, but who says he should have featured in those? Featured in English or American movies? Oi, that's a good smash. I'd like to see him be a little bit more aggressive, or actually a lot more aggressive, because I think that's been the key to putting pressure on Lin Dan, as we've seen a number of players do in the last 6 months or so.
I can't help but think back to the Thomas Cup finals in Delhi last year when Lovadays beat Kenichi Targo, and Targo was, I think, either four or five in the world at that time. And I mean, so I know he's got it in him.
Yeah.
Yeah, but quite frankly, the way Lin Dan played that opening game, I'm really not sure what you can do against that sort of.
And I don't think he has sort of regained his form yet. Lebadez been struggling also in his team matches in the Danish league, so probably should be very satisfied with the win yesterday and just take this as top quality practice.
That's a great lift. Lindan finding the range with his attacking shot once again, and interestingly, once again, not full power. Incidentally, Lovadays has actually been in a Premier Super Series quarterfinal before. That was last year at the Denmark Premier Super Series.
Yeah, I think maybe he beat Vittinghus in the first round there.
Yes, he did. 21-18, deciding game.
Yeah.
It was a tough match, I remember it.
5-2.
Vittinghus was the number 8 seed.
Yeah, but he was having a lot of trouble getting past the first round in his home tournament.
Yeah.
6 or 7 years in a row he lost in the first round, so finally this year he got past it, but not here in Fuzhou. He's nursing a small injury and decided that he wouldn't make the Asian trip. Wanted to have a long period of tournaments to recover.
7-2.
Oh, good net shot. Yeah,
it's too long. It's not often we see a body smash returned long. The problem of traveling alone is that it's not always so easy to get feedback on your game. Of course, you have your own opinion, but the coaches, yeah, here they can watch the match on TV, but otherwise they will have to get a videotape and watch the match. And from my experience, it's not always that coaches can find time to do that.
And decision in the deep forehand corner. I did notice that he was sitting having his breakfast with Scott Evans from Ireland.
Yeah.
And I know Scott was coming down to the stadium to do some training in the training courts. And I wouldn't be at all surprised, even though Scott Evans is flying back to Europe to play in the Scottish Grand Prix in Glasgow.
Has to play if it's named after him. I think it's a bit too much to name a tournament after him, but still.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But the players can help, but they don't look at the game in the same way as you coaches.
Well played.
Yeah.
Oh, great shot. Body and arm pointed in a totally different direction than the one his racket actually directed the shuttle in.
Josh Windsor, the yellow tracks on top. Oh, it's going in. Were you surprised at that? I was.
Yeah, just a little bit. But
doesn't want to waste a challenge.
No.
I like the idea, though. He was trying to take some of the initiative.
Yeah.
And smash down the forehand side there of Lin Dan. If you're going to smash somewhere, is that's the place to smash, is it?
No, not what if I could decide it, but he had no other opportunity there. He was under so much pressure that a cross smash was out of the question.
Yeah.
No, I think... clearly, the last 6-8 months, the best target for the smash is the backhand side of Lin Dan. We're pretty much sure what comes back if he gets it. It's going to be a short, straight pickup.
So it's just that it's more predictable.
It's more predictable, and he doesn't get as many back as he gets in his forehand side.
Oh, yes.
Great cross smash. He can run immediately because there's no other opportunity. I mean, if he can pick that up long or cross court, Brice Livedes, then congratulations. But almost all players can only play the short straight.
Okay,
thank you. So. That's one of the benefits of making these cross smashes from the forehand side, that you can anticipate a little bit more where the next shot is going to be.
Yeah.
Well, telling for the match that it's the court of court side of Brice Livedes that needs to be mopped. No sweat on Lin Dan's side. Not too much, anyway.
16,
That's perfect again, isn't it?
I know the opposition hasn't been as strong as we saw the match between Sindhu and Wang Xishan, but Lin Dan hasn't made any mistakes.
No.
Thank you. What I meant was mistakes on the lines, on the especially the baseline where we saw an awful lot of mistakes in the match between Sindhu and Wang Xishan. So the ability to control different conditions. Big holes, small holes, windy conditions, side drifts, changing drift, that's what makes you great.
Yeah.
18-8.
Oh, good shot. Oi. Oh, and again. Oh, that's brilliant. Two dives in that rally from Loverdays. Look at this. Up he gets. Lin Dan plays it back to the same place. A second dive. That is superb. Yeah, that's got to be a contender for play of the day. Exactly 30 minutes of play and match point opportunities for Lin Dan. Well, he is human after all. This time, and the scoreline of 21-6, 21-10. He wants his shirt, I think.
Yeah.
Yeah. That would certainly be a memento. I'm not sure he's going to be granted that wish, though. There we go. Confirmation that Lin Dan safely through to the quarterfinal with victory over Brice Lavidez of France. 21-6, 21-10 in 30 minutes of play. So our three singles matches for today have been concluded. And a night for the home fans with both Wang Shuxian and Lin Dan. Will the home fans get a hat-trick of victories? Because next on court is Tsai Yun and Lu Kai in the men's doubles. Up against Hiroyuki Endo and Kenichi Hawakawa, the number five seeds from Japan. So the players for this men's doubles encounter shake each other's hands, has become traditional at most sporting events. Tsai Yun and Lu Kai of China against Kenichi Hawakawa and Hiroyuki Endo. There is Hiroyuki Endo. He'll turn 29 next month from Saitama, in the suburbs of Tokyo. His partner already 29 years of age. They're currently number six in the world ranking. They have been as high as two, a total of 6 weeks as number two in the world. That was last year. Number three on the Super Series list at the moment. And their win-loss record for the year, 14 tournaments. And they've been in five semi-finals. Three of those five semi-finals in Super Series events. And of course the World Championships as well, where they won the bronze medal. So their opponents, there is the tall man, Lu Kai, 191. That's just over 6'3". Turned 23 last month from Nanning in southern China. His partner, well, he's 35 from Suzhou in Jiangsu province. And of course, he is half of probably one of the most famous men's doubles partnerships in the sport of badminton, because with Fu Haifeng, won everything apart from this China Open. There we can see this will be the second meeting between these two pairs. First time they met was in the first round of this year's Singapore Super Series, which for the Chinese pair was a disappointment because they were the defending champions in Singapore, having won the Singapore Super Series title of 2014. So only eight tournaments this year for Tsai Yun and Lu Kai as a partnership. Did win the Swiss Grand Prix gold in Basel. Semi-finalists at the Asian Championships. But this is only their second Super Series, second round of the year. Reached the second round in Japan, where they lost the eventual champions Li Yongdae and Yu Young Sung. Chinese coaching bench, Zhang Jun. And I think that was Chen Chi Chu, wasn't it?
Yeah, I think you're right.
Oh, their Japanese coach, Ryo Nimanaki.
Ladies and and gentlemen, on my right, Chai Yun and Liu Kai, China. And on my left, Hiroyuki Endo and Kenichi Hayakawa, Japan. Kenichi Hayakawa to serve to Chai Yun, love all, play. One love.
Well, one wonders how much longer we'll have the pleasure of watching Chai Yun reach the final of the China Open in 2006, lost out to Marcus Kido and Hendra Setia won in that final. And it seems astonishing, Steen, we alluded to it earlier, didn't we, about Chai Yun and Fu Haifeng, for all they achieved, Olympic medals, world titles, All England titles. Never.
I must say, I'm almost shocked. I would never have guessed that.
Yeah.
If there were a question with how many China Open did they win, zero, two, four, or six? I would guess more likely four or six. Than I would never have guessed they'd never won it.
Well, we're talking earlier in the day, weren't we, about the psychology of sport. And I wonder if that came into it at all, such expectations all the years that they were world number one as a pair. I wonder, in a way, if that also
came second in the Olympics
in Beijing. I was just about to talk about that and whether that was an influence playing on home soil. But I do like the way that China Badminton has split up Chai Yun and Fu Haifeng and said, right, okay, want both of you to bring on younger players.
Yeah.
Oh, that's a good rally, isn't it?
Yeah, and Fu Haifeng, you know, Jiang Nan is not so young, and he's still young, but he's not sort of inexperienced. He's also an Olympic champion, but they really formed a formidable partnership there, and in my opinion, the best Chinese men's doubles right now.
Yeah, four Super Series tournament finals this year for Fu Haifeng and Jiang Nan. All England, Singapore, Indonesia, Japan. But sadly, had to withdraw from this event.
They did?
Yeah, number three seeds, and they withdrew before the tournament began. Oh. So they gave a walkover to Hashimoto and Hirata. Good rally. Yeah. Well, he always was superb at the net, Chai Yun. Taken.
Service over. 5-3.
Oh, he had to be careful there. That again. Oh, super!
6-3.
Look at that little hold and flick deep into that forehand corner. Of rackets. Yeah, smashed racket.
That's really hard to return with a broken racket.
Yeah. Not just a simple string. Take a look at this. Look at it. Oh, my goodness. There's no hope of playing the next shot. Yeah. That won't see another day. Lovely defence, isn't it? Just guiding it flat over the net. Nice change of pace.
Yeah, great rally.
Oh, that was going out. Good rally. Oh, that's brilliant. What a super shot from Lukai.
Very, very steep shot.
Mm. Chinese pair were quarter finalists here last year. Lost to the then world champions, Go Sung-hyung and Shin Baek-chul, in three games.
And it really is interesting to see what's going to happen in the future with this men's doubles here with Lukai. Who is he going to play with? Is he going to play on with Chaiyun or switch completely to Liu Cheng, who is played with in Denmark Premier and was it Australia Open where they went on to the final?
Reached the final, yeah.
And it's interesting because Lukai's role is different in two combinations. Here he's it's better for the pair if he's on the baseline, but playing with Liu Cheng, he plays a very, very good net player or primarily net player role there.
Yeah.
One of the reasons to continue this constellation here could be if Liu Cheng is focusing on the mixed doubles for the Rio Olympics, of course, in tough competition with two other Chinese pairings.
Yeah, one of the Chinese pairings is this man again, isn't it? With Wang Yaxiong.
Yeah.
Of course, Xu Chen and Ma Jin is the obvious other pair. All vying for those two Olympic places. Defending champions, I think, without question, barring injury.
Yeah, they're more or less given.
Yeah. Yeah, that's a beautiful placement. Nice way to draw back level. Oh yes, that's lovely. Well played by Endo. He just doesn't have the speed he once did. So you're Good serve. Oh, my goodness. When you see him play shots like that, it's very easy to understand why he's the reigning Olympic champion, four-time world champion, six world championship medals. Yeah, 10-10. Big gap between the two Chinese players and the advantage, albeit just one solitary point, is with the Japanese pair here at the mid-game interval.
Yeah, and a bit of a strange first game so far. I feel like both pairs actually have more to give. Down from like 3.5 meters there. A jump and an arm and a racket and 191. That's 3.5 meters, more or less.
Good attacking play by the Japanese pair.
And I really like to see the last two smashes, which were steeper and softer than we normally see the Japanese, who are just firing away with hard smashes. But this was clever smashes.
In fact, I think during the All England final, their first one in 2013, of course, they were in two consecutive All England finals, Japanese pair. I can remember talking about the fact that they just played at 100 miles an hour the whole time. So you're right, they have developed their game and they're using these slower, steeper smashes, a few drop shots occasionally in recent tournaments. I've seen them play.
And got rewarded at the Worlds with a bronze medal. I'm not sure, but I guess you know that, Jill. That it must be the first men's doubles medal for Japan at the Worlds.
It was indeed.
Yeah.
No, it wasn't. It was the second.
It was the second, yeah, that's
2007,
right.
2007, Sakamoto and Ikeda.
Yeah.
It was the first men's singles medal at the World.
For Momota.
It was just lost against Son Wen-ho of Korea in the men's singles.
Strong second round match.
Yeah. No way that was going to come back. It's an interesting Japanese pair, though, isn't it, Steen? I mean, six Super Series tournament finals, not one title.
Yeah.
I mean, they get so close so often. You know, what did I say? Three Super Series semi-finals already this year, five semi-finals in total, if you include the German Grand Prix gold and the World Championships as well. So they're always there or thereabouts.
Yeah. It's, I don't know exactly what it is, but I feel that they don't have exactly that one thing that they're better at than anyone else. I mean, Asan and Sechuan are better in the service situation than anyone else. The Koreans are better in the defense than anyone else. And Fu Haifeng, Jiang Nan, I'm not sure they're better than anyone else, but perhaps number two after each of the two other pairs. So
good running. Right. Oh, it's called out.
Yeah,
well left. Yeah, I know what you mean, because yeah, to win titles at this level, there's got to be something special. That's great judgment and good call, line judge.
Yeah, something special, because when you move up to the semifinals, then you play pairs that has some top skill, either in the attack, in the defense, in the service situation, in the tactical game, whatever it is.
Yeah. Yeah, perfect far exchange. Well, just to emphasize the point that we've been making, Kenichi Hawakawa and Hiroyuki Endo, they've been in 13 tournaments since they've been playing together. They've only won 3 of them. The last title that they won was July 2012, at the US Grand Prix Gold. And they've played in 7 finals since.
And the US Grand Prix Gold is a considerably lower tier than the Super Series.
Absolutely.
Not because it's in US or because it's the Grand Prix Gold, but it's played in during the summer where a lot of the stronger pairings are preparing for the Worlds.
Yeah. Oh yes, that was a nice chat. And again, this is how they've developed their games. Yeah, brilliant.
Excellent play.
Yeah.
Just the favorite position for the Japanese pairing, with Endo working at the back court, having the role of the playmaker, making all kinds of different shots without making mistakes, but sort of trying to set it up for his partner Hayakawa at the front court. They've been in control all this first game. Endo and Hayakawa.
Yes, right into the deep corner.
Samusova, 14-18.
Played.
Yeah.
There we saw some of the skills at the front court from Lukai. He's been flicking a lot, Chayun. I like that. I mean, if you have a good flick serve and a reasonable defense, I mean, there's no point in serving short services all the time.
Yeah, that's a very, very good rally altogether from the Chinese pair.
Thank you.
Service over, 19-16.
Oh, that was good defense. Yeah, good reactions by the Japanese players. And that has earned them three game point opportunities. Goodness, good angled smash. Oh, you're right about the height that must be coming down from Liu Kai's racket. There's another wonderful example. Done well early stages of that rally, Liu Kai. Minutes of play. Coach having a bit of a drink there. Yeah. Thirsty work, yeah. This coaching. All right, players, you just carry on, boys.
But I like that. Yeah, we won the first game, so no need to rush it here. We've got 2 minutes, and
yeah.
Things are actually going according to plan.
Yeah. You're right, though. I always got the sense that the Japanese were just a little bit better in that opening game. I always felt they were going to win it.
Yeah, they came a little bit close in the end, Chae-yoon and Liu Kai, but they never really challenged. I think one of the keys for the Japanese pair to become even stronger in terms of Super Series achievements is to become better in their opposite roles, that Endo must become a little bit better at the net and Hayakawa must become a little bit better from the back court,
yeah.
So that they can survive these situations where their opponents have them changed around.
Second game.
The defense nowadays is so good that you won't always be able to have your preferred position.
Yeah. Oh, yes. But
one glove.
There's the favoured formation.
Three.
Oh, that's delightful. I like that. Oh, there's the change of pace. Then the power. And change of pace again. Well worked, Rally.
They're continuing the second game where they left in the first. Dominating more of the rallies. Oh, I think his racket is broke.
Yeah.
Or what? No?
It didn't. It didn't sound right, did it?
Huh?
Oh, it's not going off to change his racket. Maybe it was just the noise of the cork of the shuttle hitting the top of the tape. Something sounded odd, though, didn't it? Yeah, it's a fault because he touched it. Well, looks up at the lights. Certainly in the matches we've seen him with Lu Cheng. That's what he's been doing an awful lot, those interceptions at the net.
Yeah, but and he gets a little bit better working conditions when he plays with Lu Cheng because he's a much harder hitter from the base, from the backcourt than Cha Yun.
That so is delightful.
I'm pretty sure that the combination of Lu Kai and Liu Cheng is actually now stronger than the combination that we're seeing on court here. It's just a matter of whether you can divide Liu Cheng's attention between two categories. Lu Kai, of course, also playing mixed doubles with Huang Yachong.
There, did he think it was going to go long of the back line? He didn't seem to be half-hearted the way he hit that.
Well played.
Yeah.
It seems that when the Japanese pair put pressure on Cha Yun at the backcourt, then they're in trouble, Cha Yun and Lu Kai.
Oh, what a backhand there from Endo.